no mistake, the devil has a plan for your life too. The devil wants you to live this lifestyle of sin that in the end brings destruction and death. You see, the Bible tells us, for the wages of sin is death. You see, the best thing that you're going to earn for your sinful lifestyle today is death. That's the best you're going to get. So why do we come out here today? We come out here today because we want to warn you about God's wrath that awaits you, because you're storing up wrath for yourself on the day of judgment. I know a lot of you laugh and you say, but we're born again Christians, we're on your side, take it easy. Let me tell you, Jesus said you'd know them by their fruit. And out of the abundance of the heart the mouth speaks, by your words, by the way you talk, by the way you walk and you dress, we know that you're not born again Christian. You see, the Bible says that God is light, and in him there is no darkness. If you people are claiming to be born again and you're walking in the light as he is in the light, you wouldn't be here associated with this darkness today, this pride. You see, God's going to destroy this, and God will destroy you also. But you see, God has given you a chance today. He's given you another breath to breathe right now. Oh, God is long-suffering. You see, we all deserve to die and go to hell right now. But thank goodness. Thank the Lord that he made a way. You see, that was the bad news. Let me tell you some good news. A lot of people say, tell me some good news. One verse that you're all familiar with is John 3:16. But there's a very key word in there. It says that whosoever believes. What about the people who do not believe? You see, those people are in big trouble with God. But you see, that man named Jesus, he died and he hung willingly upon a cross so that you can be set free from your sins. So that you can be set free from your homosexuality. You don't think that's a big deal now? Well, you will stand before the God of the Bible. This lifestyle that he says is an abomination. You see, you're going to think that it's going to be a big problem. And these street preachers that were so loud, I wish we had bigger speakers to get a lot louder. Because on that day, it's going to be like a video camera. And this day is going to be played back before your very eyes. And he's going to say, you had a chance to turn away from your wicked lifestyle. You had a chance to turn away from a lifestyle that you knew that would send you to hell. But you chose to live in your lifestyle. You chose to follow after the devil. You chose to do that which is evil, instead of choosing to follow the God of the Bible. Then he's going to bind you hand and foot, and he's going to say, depart from me. He's going to cast you into that lake of fire which burns forever. See, you can't never come out of that place, and people can't come to you. So we stand out here today, lifting up our voice, crying aloud, saying, how long will you simple and love your simple ways? I know a lot of you say, oh, well, I'm never going to call upon the name of the Lord. Well, you will. The Bible says that people will say, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name and cast out devils and done many wonderful things? Oh, but the sad part is he's going to say, depart from me, you that work iniquity, for I never knew you. Oh, can you imagine standing before God on judgment day and he says, I don't even know who you are? That ought to scare the hell out of you right there, to know that the God of the Bible is going to say he never knew you. And then be cast into that lake of fire which burns forever. You see, I know a lot of you people, as I was walking around witnessing to some of you people earlier today, you said that God loves us just the way we are. Let me tell you something. The Bible says that God is angry with the wicked every day. Your lifestyle puts you in that wicked category. So God is angry with you. He's not loving you just the way you are. Yes? He loves you enough to die for you. But he's given you a chance to turn away from your sin and turn your life. saved, to be set free.